Hello friend, this is the first part of the series on the introduction to database management system. So today we will see that what are database, what are different types of database. So today we will spend more time on understanding the that particular database and the database management system overview. So the first thing is like, what is database? So to understand database, you should understand that what are the data basically. So data is something related to, let's say you are working in a industry, in a maybe in a software industry or maybe in a hotel industry. So the data there refers to the hotel data or maybe the software that you are selling to somebody, or maybe if I take example of, for example, LinkedIn. So LinkedIn, the database is user data to whom they are connected and so on. So if I summarize, the data is something which is interrelated information. So when I say the interrelated information, there could be many types of information, like the data, for example, the data could be of text file, it could be of image, it could be video, and so on. There could be any number of type of data. Like, and to give an example, as I was telling, let's say if we take about the college, the college will be having the database. Let's say this is the database of the college. So what it will be having, the data of student, it will be having the database of faculty, it will be having the database of department. Database means, when I say database, that means table of department, table of student, of faculty, of courses, of like around test, and so on. There could be any. If I talk about like another example, which is, let's take Amazon. So though Amazon will be having very broad database, definitely the one that I'm going to discuss will be very, very, very limited one. But if I see at the very surface level, they will be having one table, which is referring to user information. User information, that means his name, email ID, his shipping address, billing address, and so on. Even this address could be broken down into further different tables. So we are not going in that depth, and just giving a very surface overview that an Amazon database will be having the user table. It will be also having the product table. When I say product, that means what all products it is containing, like maybe a furniture, maybe clothes, and so on. So they'll be having some mapping, some primary key like a product ID and the information around those. Then they will be having the cart table, which the cart table is referring to what all that particular user has placed this product in the cart, and maybe it will be also having the information around the checkout and so on. So like this, there will be many products or maybe even many tables which an Amazon will be having. So the next question comes around that, do we really need the database? Can't we save this data in the text file or maybe an MS or Excel? So the question comes around, why we need the database? So let's for a moment, let's think that we don't need a database, and we are storing the data in the file, let's say, and similarly there are n number of n files. Okay, so what will happen is, means this will perfectly work fine, you can store the data in your files, but again try to understand that this will be working fine till your enterprise or college, or maybe these are working till a very small scale. When I say small scale, that means, let's say let's say there is a tutor who is teaching to 5 students. Then maybe for that tutor, maintaining a simple Excel file with five different entities, means five different rows, will be sufficient to monitor that how exactly the data is being referred there. But think it of as the think it of like Allen Coaching Center, which is one of the famous I think most of you are from engineering background, so you must be knowing. So let's say you're taking about the Allen data. So now the number of students enrolled in Allen all over the India would be definitely in lakhs. And you can no more rely on the simple Excel file to save this large amount of data. So if I summarize, like, why we need the data, why we need a database, the very first point is the size of data. This is one very important aspect we need to understand, that the file system is not a scalable solution, so that you cannot rely on that file system for the huge increase in the data or in the existing data present. The second very important part is ease of updating data. What do we mean by ease of updating data? Ease as we understand that how easily or how comfortable we are in updating the data. So if we see there are, let's say, maybe thousands of files, maybe we have to write a set of scripts to implement any changes in this file, and even I need to go and pick a particular line and then execute. So it will be relatively tough to implement these things in such a file. But rather, if you have different tables and these tables are connected, so it's fairly easy to just execute a command on this, and it will take into consideration wherever the other parts are involved. It will just automatically update the other places also. So in terms of the ease of updating data, it's fairly simple to update in the database compared to the file system. The next is taking into consideration the failure situation. Let's say you are making any changes in the file system. So it might happen that maybe the hardware crash, or maybe the system turns off, or any XYZ thing happens. So your overall files will be in inconsistent state. Some will be having properly implemented data, some will be having maybe some broken sort of data. But if you think of the database, the database management system take into account that it first makes a copy of the existing data, then execute the set of implementation. If at any point the things break, then it will regain the original database. But if it is not and everything is executed, then it will automatically update this as the means the automatically the final copy will be updated with this original copy. So this failure situation is again handled in the database, which is not the case with the overall file system. Second, which is again in line with the above points, inconsistency. What do you mean by inconsistency? Inconsistency means that, let's say you have a file A, you have another file B, and then you have third file C. Now, if you remember, like in the last overview section, I talked about the normalization. Now, let's suppose there is some particular segment which is common in all the three. Then I need to go again and change things on all these things, and it will not be very much consistent, because a multiple user, let's say, is accessing all these three, one is making any changes, the other will be maybe some will be accessing the partial data and some will be accessing the latest data. But when it comes to database also, it could happen that there are multiple places repetitive data, but the database will put proper locks while implementing any execution, so that rest all the people are not referring to inconsistent data, and you are having the proper accuracy among the data. The accuracy is maintained, that if it is referring to 50 and if some, let's say, some T person is making changes to A, the other X person cannot refer till this T has completed, because this T has executed the lock on this A. So that is one thing which we need to understand in terms of accuracy and maintaining the consistency. The last few point is around the security. It's fairly simple to make any changes in the files compared to the database, because like you cannot put much restriction on the file system, which again involves many efforts, many programming and all those aspects. But with the database, the DBA, database administrator, provides certain restriction as who can access and who can make changes on the database. So with that particular section, so for example, this is database, and the DBA, that is database administrator, has put admin role to developers. Now developers can only go and modify the database. Anyone like, and to the, let's say, analyst is having the read access. So analyst cannot go and modify the database, but when it comes to file, maybe analyst, even any XYZ person can go and modify that thing. So that is again one of the important part we need to understand, that why we are accessing, or maybe why we are altogether going with the database, why it is important, and why things will break when it comes to big business, and it will work properly when it is the like small business or maybe a small data. The next that we will see is around the types of database. So as I was also telling in the overview, there depending on the use cases, we come across different type of database. Like so some may prefer storing the data in a tabular format. Some will find it comfortable that hey, this is my student's record, and I find it comfortable in storing the ID, student ID and name and age here. So it's like one name, Shubham, age maybe 24, second maybe XYZ, age 20, and third maybe ABC, age 50, for example. So this particular data is very much okay when it comes to the tabular representation. But tomorrow, if I talk about the social networking, then you cannot go ahead with this, that A is connected to B, B is connected to C, B is also connected to D, and so on. It will be very big data in that case. So what we do is, in that case, there is an A data, then there is one B data, B is connected to C, B is connected to D, B is connected to some more and number of people. So LinkedIn or any social networking platform can very much relate it with this one. Okay, so this is one. This is two type of database, and there are many more. We'll see this one on one. The very first is the relational database. What I mean relational database, that means more like a tabular. Means in short, it's called the relational database management system. Relational database, that means you have things in a tabular format. When I say tabular, that means in a table notation. When we'll see in the coming lecture what is entity relational model, then we'll more understand around tabular model. But for now, think it of as a simple table notation where you are having all the details in a table architecture like an Excel. So this is one of the relational database understanding. The second and few of the common, very common database of relation is MySQL. Oracle. So these two are one of the very commonly used industry means database, which is falling in the category of the relational database. Then you also have the cloud database. If you had worked on the AWS, Amazon Web Service, so you will be having knowledge, like you can deploy your codes there, you can perform your machine learning code and maybe execute some of those. Also, if you have worked on any of the Microsoft Microsoft API, so you must have come across the Azure also, Microsoft Azure. So this is again some of the database which is provided by the Amazon and Microsoft to implement those things. Now the third important database is NoSQL. So what does a new NoSQL means? So SQL, first of all, before you understand NoSQL, what is SQL? SQL, by the name you understand, as it's a structured query language. So structured query language, that means to execute or maybe to fetch particular data from a tabular format, we follow the structured query language. We write SQL queries to fetch data from the particular tables. Now NoSQL is entirely different from this particular tabular database. So within NoSQL lies the different type. So NoSQL is simply like not an SQL. So which are not an SQL database? Like MongoDB, like Redis, also like Hierarchy, like graph based. So if I talk about this MongoDB is mostly like a document, or maybe you can say JSON type, where you store the data in a JSON. And now if you don't know about JSON, that's completely okay. It's something like JavaScript object notation, where you store the data in an object representation. So it's okay if you don't understand. Just understand that it's in MongoDB, pretty much the data are implemented or kept in a document format, unlike the tabular notation of the relational database. In Redis, we have things in a key value pairing. You can think it of Redis as like hash. Very simple example of Redis is hash. Hierarchy is, I've already told, around the tree based architecture, and graph also I told around the social networking example. Apart from this, there is one last also aspect which falls in this only, which is object based. If you have worked on Java and those aspects, you must be knowing the object oriented programming. So it's like that we are also saving the separate object. This will be object 1, this will be object 2, this will be object 3, and so on. Don't confuse it with the exact graph architecture. Graph is very different, but an object means this object is altogether representing a separate entity, and there could be an encapsulation of separate object, maybe object 4. So this object notation is altogether different. It's something correlates with the object oriented programming, and graph based is something where interconnected entities, that entity could be separate, that entity could be altogether different entity, or it could be altogether different information also. So this was the overview. If you just quickly summarize, we saw that what is the database containing the interrelated data, and why we need a database, because as soon as that size is increasing, you need accuracy around the security. You need to work on the database, and you cannot rely on the file system. Around the type of database, the first we have seen the relational database, where the data are kept pretty much in a tabular format. The second one is on the cloud database, which is the AWS and the Azure, which again makes use of the either the tabular or maybe the MongoDB and those aspects. The third is the no SQL, which is simple like a not an SQL, and in which the false the MongoDB, which is document type data structure, document type database. The red is which is more like a key value pairing, a simple example like hash. Hierarchy, which I've already told, like a tree based with nth branch, not binary tree, nth branch tree. And graph means all the entities are connected. Object means it's more like an object oriented language where you are representing each object with an entity. So in the next class, we will spend some time around the architecture, what are different architecture of the database. Thank you.